So in the last episode, we have installed PHP unit and created this phpunit.xml file. And here we have defined firstly the XML version tag, simple one. Then we are giving this bootstrapped to start from where. Then we are saying that, okay, whenever you are running the test, give me result in colors. Then verbose, that means give some more information. And whenever you have any failed test, just stop executing other test. And then we are defining test suits and then one test suit, singular one, and naming it unit and defining that, okay, every test is now inside tests folder. Here it is the tests folder. We have created unit folder inside this, and inside this we will create our test. But before creating the test, you can see to run a test, we need to say vendor slash bin slash PHP unit. And that will run the test because we don't have any test. That's why we are getting no test executed, but this is, I don't like. Okay. So what I need to have a simple flow to run the test. For that, you need to go and install a package or extension for this VS Code. So let's press Control Shift and X for Windows user and Command Shift and X for Mac user to have this extension window open on the left side. Then you need to type here better PHP unit. Search for this thing, and if it is not giving, let's search like this. So second one, better PHP unit. So let's just install it, reload this VS Code. And now press Control Shift and E or Command Shift and E to go back to this Explorer. And if I now want to run the test, so let's even close this terminal. I want to run the test. So what I will do, I will press Control Shift and P for Windows user and Command Shift and P for Mac user. And now I will say run. And you can see we have this better PHP, or you can just simple search for better PHP. So let's say better PHP and hit enter. And you can see it says document of undefined. It says better PHP unit, open a file to run command. So what happening here, we are saying to better PHP that you need to run a test, but where is the test? There is no test. So let's create a test now. So let's close this window, and here in this unit folder, let's create a file called first test.php, initialize PHP tag. And here let's create a class, and class name is first test. And this is going to extends, and this is going to extend which thing? This is going to extend our PHP unit tests. So it will be like test case. So this test case has to be this one, PHP unit framework test case, not Sebastian Bergman and all these things, just this one. And because this is created, and yeah, we have done this. Now again, let's try our better PHP. So Command Shift P or Control Shift P for Windows user, better PHP unit, hit enter. And yeah, you can see it says tests 1, assertion 0, warning 1. This means it is working. That means the better PHP is working. But even that, you can see if I type this Command Shift and P again, we have shortcuts Command K or Command R. Right now I am on this class. I will say Command R. It's not doing that. So let's go to preferences, keyboard shortcuts, and here let's search for better PHP. So better PHP, yeah, we have this. So key binding is Control R, so why not make this Control R. And yes, it is done. So if I go here and press Control R, it run the tests. So close this, and yeah, this is good. But what if the file is closed and if I press Control R? It says again, hey, what you are going to run, I don't know. So again, if you go to preferences and keyboard shortcuts, you will see that it says run previous one. So why not give a shortcut to run the previous one? I will give Control Shift and R for running the previous command or previous test. So here we have, let's say Control R to run this test. That's good. Close this line. Control Shift and R, that will execute your last test. So right now we don't have any test. So yeah, we are going to write test. So this is good. Let's say public function, and for every function, if that is a test, you need to prefix word test. So test first time, but it will be better if you give your test name descriptive. So what I will say, test, and our test is multiplication of two number. So multiplication, and I will use camel case, of two number. So this is good. And to assert something, you need to simply say dollar this arrow assert, and assert what? Let's say assert true. Okay, and inside this, whatever you give, so what it's like, whatever you give inside parenthesis, if that returns true, it will say okay, you are expecting true, that means asserting true, and you are getting true. So let's say true here, and because I am on this function, if I press command R or control R, it will execute the test, and you can see we have okay, one test, one assertion, and that is on the green colored. Color is good, nice. So this is good, but as you can see, if I say here false, and you know, I will close this window, and if I press command shift R or control shift R for PC users, Windows users, it will execute the last command, and which is saying okay, it fails. Why it fails? And you have the description why it fails, because first test, this the test name actually failed asserting that false is true. You are getting false, expecting true, that's why this test fails. So let's now go and once more make something. So I have one variable called 5, another variable called let's say 4, and I want to multiply it. So there is multiplication. So C will be 5 multiplied by 4, and we know 5 fours are 20. So what we are expecting here, asserting 20, so C has to be 20. But how we can assert that the value of C has to be 20? So it's like assert, and what we are going to assert, assert equals which thing? We need to provide two things that has to be equal. So assert C has to be equal to 20. This is good. So now run the test, control R, and it says asserted and successfully done. But what if I say 21, 201 is okay also, and control R, it fails. And this is exactly how you can use PHP unit just from the scratch. So before moving to the next video, let's just tweak something. You know, whenever you are writing the test, you need to make sure the function name has to be descriptive, and descriptive name becomes longer. And if I see it directly, I can't see exact what I have written. So why not do one thing? So I will use, instead of camel case, I will separate each word with underscore to have a better clarity. So like this, and test multiplication of two number. And if I try this, yes, it is still working. Yeah, we know it has to be 20 to pass this test. That's okay. And this is more clear in terms of readability. The next thing is, you can see for every test, if we don't use this test prefix here, if I save, run the test, it says no test executed. You need to make sure the test has to be there, the word test initially, prefix it. But instead of this, you can do one thing more. You can just create the doc box here, and that will be like /(2)* and then your docs, and then the asterisk and again /. So here you need to say @test. If I remove this and try to run it, yeah, it says no test executed. But if I write this one, run it, yes, you can see it says one tested and that is successful. So just use these little tips to make your test more clear and faster. And if you have liked this episodes and if you have not subscribed, just go and subscribe to this channel and don't forget to hit the bell icon to get the notification whenever I upload any video. Follow BitFumes on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram and LinkedIn, and we will meet in the next episode. Till then, goodbye.